I want freaking access to game servers. And what's pissing me off is I can't log in, so it may actually have to be Blood Crow's email account saying it's been accessed by more than one computer or by too many places, and that he needs to check his email account for that info.
Or they're in the process of installing your server, and so they will give you a new update page when it's actually updated.
Yeah, but you should be able to log in and see the status of your game server.
Yeah.
Well, you should be able to log into the account.
They showed you before when they were still in progress of trying to get it started. They probably needed time to make sure that your payment would clear. Now that the payment's cleared, they're probably in the process of installing the game on the server for you. And then it'll probably be, the next time you can actually log into it, it'll probably say up to date, ready to go.
True.
I mean, usually this only takes about a half hour to an hour at most. The fact that it's taken this long...
J-Kill, what's up, you know, my friend?
It's kind of a pain in the butt, but I think you guys will probably be on here shortly the next time you can actually log into that account.
As soon as Blood Crow wakes up, should be in an hour.
Or before that, if you try to log in and it lets you log in. Because it's probably just not giving you updates because it's in the process of being handled. Actually in the process of being handled.
Well, the error I'm getting is invalid login / password. And that bothers me.
So the account could be temporarily held while they're trying to get everything loaded.
I hope you're right, Scott Plants. I really do. Because I don't want to have to wait for Blood Crow to start playing. You know what I mean?
Well, I'm sure you could probably Google and get his telephone number. You know his address. It was on his profile page for the longest time.
Yeah, but I think he's got like a magic jack or some shit. Or no, he's got telephone line through his cable service. Was it Comcast Business?
Yeah, he's running Comcast Business Phone. Which is pretty much the same as the residential side, just running off of a freaking modified business gateway with the phone modem on it.
Yeah. Yo, what up, a handsome, cool guy? What up, Jake Hill? How are you guys doing? What are you guys up to? I want to know. I'm curious. J-Kill, you can play this. They actually have low computer settings, like low-end computer settings. You can actually play this game now, finally. Four people entered. Who is getting 2,000 GC? Swede boy, say something in the chat. You have 2 minutes on the clock, my friend. 2 minutes. Say something in chat to claim.
J-Kill, if my wife can run this on a 4-year-old HP laptop, I mean, yeah, she sits on the load screen for 15 minutes before she actually gets into the game, but it does run, I'm pretty sure you can run it.
You guys missed the GC giveaway, but not the game giveaways. I gave away GC Camelot 2, I gave away GC, so no worries guys, everyone can enter GC giveaways, it's just game giveaways. We have, we haven't done too many of them lately, because there's been no active chat. I don't know who's actually here and who's lurking, and I need a minimum of 3 people to enter to assign a game giveaway, because I can't just give games to a viewer, because then that's just not right to everybody else. GC, what's that? GC is short for game cartridges here on the channel. And your game cartridges are basically your money. You can gamble them away with bank heists, or you can save them up and use those to buy tickets when we do game giveaways. The game giveaways can be anything that you find anywhere on the internet. So we have all sorts of games available through Steam, through the Humble Bundles, through G2A, Green Man Gaming, you name it. We've got access to all sorts of game giveaways. However, this I paid for my own. And just so you guys know, no, I do not have keys for Ark. I wish I did, but I do not have keys. I sent a tweet out, and I'm not sure what's going on, guys. There's too many big streamers playing this game like crazy, so that could be why. Way too many big streamers. Hell, Gold Glove had like 50,000 people. Remember J-Kill, exclamation GC, it's so much easier. It's actually a lot easier now, exclamation GC. Let's see. I'm gonna go back to my little spot. And I have a spear. I need more fiber, huh? Oh, cool. Yep. It can trigger off of game cartridges. Oh, you forgot the D. I figured game cartridges is way too long to spell. So we shorten the command down. It's still called game cartridges, but in short, GC works. CartDude JP, thank you for the follow, my friend. Stick around, you'll see the alert hit anywhere from a few seconds to a few minutes, my friend. Enjoy. And thank you for that follow. Hang out, collect them game cartridges, and get yourselves ready in 17 minutes for a game giveaway. What's up?
GC, my friend. Game giveaway. Good game. No. Bad joke.
Oh, yeah, I know what GG is, nice, but I just didn't hear it because of me pounding on shit with my headphones in. Everything overlaps. What's shanks? Basically, you know, you stab somebody. That is a command. I forgot about that one, J-Kill. J-Kill here was one of our first mods in the very beginning. He started making commands for Nightbot. It was kind of cool. It's just a fun command. That's all shanking is. Exclamation shank and the person, and you stab that person directly. Yep, J-Kill made it. Look at it. It's a giant dino turd. Medium dinosaur feces.
Yeah, wait till you see one. Let one go on a freaking hill and the damn thing starts rolling at you.
Dude, the brontosaur, the giant one, that thing was almost as big as me.
I hate to see what the ones that come off the megalodons look like. And if they float.
So, did they basically state that monsters, dinos, and animals and stuff, is if you knock them out, to check their inventory all the time because they could be carrying rare stuff? Is that stated in the forums?
The devs haven't actually said anything about that. But one thing I did know, notice there have been players posting on like Reddit and shit. Saying basically the same thing. Check the freaking loot. Or check their inventory because they other players on other servers have been finding stuff too.
Oh, nice.
There's one guy, he said he found like freaking 8 or 9 freaking crystals on one of them.
And that's just at random?
Yeah.
That's kind of awesome.
I'll be right back. I gotta make a trip to the head.
Alright. CartDude JP, thank you for that follow and the support. Hell yeah, my friend. Thank you so much. Ferniner, I play on a private server currently. We're waiting on Blood Crow's server to finish because that was bought between him and Borderland Games server. It's going to be like 6 streaming communities servers. So this server is going to be able to stay up. We're going to try and run it up to 70 men as fast as possible. As long as we have the resources to do so. That's the bigger part. Must have the resources to do so. Okay, I should mark that as well. I should make that a chat command. I'm realizing that right this second. JKill, yes, I've tamed a dino. Oops. Alright, there we go, guys. Another thing saved and debought forever. That specific command, if you guys want to know about the ARK server, !ARK server, one word. And you guys get to see. You wanna donate to the community ran clan server? Go here and help out. All money goes directly to the server site, no one else. So yeah, guys. Borderland Gaming's server alone, or community gave us 2 months access free, so we didn't have to pay, but they donated to the community, and it's freaking awesome. We have up to 40 people can join that server. This is not that server. When you join that server, you'll start out fresh and new like everyone else, and we're planning on trying to make tribe wars. But considering game servers maxes out at 70 people, if we have like 4 main tribes, that would be freaking epic. What did I miss? How does the construction working? Doritas 2, you didn't miss too much. Quite a few lurkers in here. Heck yeah, JKill. I feel like Swede Boy did not. I did that, didn't I? I did exactly that. I bet you I did what I think I did. Where is it? Not seeing it. Where is it? That face, holy crap. Yeah, I did not see Swede Boy say anything in chat, so we are rerunning that raffle. I accidentally cleared it. So we're rerunning that raffle right now. I just like was like, oh yeah, click. But guys, I've been running since 7 o'clock last night, guys. Me being an idiot, I kind of fucked up. Well, there just went my my total max at 17. Just set myself up to craft hide armors. That's hide pants and hide shirts. Wow, that's a lot of hide. Hell yeah, look at you guys. Definitely getting in on the sea giveaway. Exclamation enter. Oh, that's a bunch of you talking about enter. Well, exclamation enter, guys. Exclamation enter. And then if you guys really don't know if you're actually in it yet, press exclamation GC and there should be a little K next to your name. Just so you guys know. Thatch, it's not even really that big a deal. Here we go. Yeah, that saber-tooth tiger killed me with over 100 flint on my body. I had like 200 of every resource, practically, except for wood. Hey, Scott Plants.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I think Blood Crow needs to log into his email account. It's kind of
bites. Why are you not getting a message saying that it's been blocked?
No, it's just still invalid login and username. And it's exactly what he gave me.
I wonder if his card got... He said he was using his card. I wonder if his card got declined.
Shouldn't have, because it went $117 went straight to the account. Like, people donated directly to the account, not to us. So the account has $117 on it.
Yeah, those people still have to clear, though.
And that's what Blood Crow bought the server with, was the money on the account, I think. Unless it was his money.
I think he said he used his credit card to take care of it. He was just waiting for money from Borderland that was supposed to be sent to him, but he was using his card to take care of the deal.
Okay, then that's what happened then. And we're just going to have to wait for Blood Crow to get on and check it, because I'm sitting here playing and... It's going to be really messed up if he's not getting up until 1 or 2 in the afternoon his time, and I'm sitting here doing all this grinding out, waiting for him, for the server to come up. Because I really want to play on our server.
Then I would just cut it now. I mean, why keep grinding away at this and doing stuff here if you're not going to be coming back to it and you're going to the new server?
Because I like playing the game.
But I'd say go get rest. come back at 1 o'clock with Blood Crow and play then. I'm only saying that now because I'm leaving. I got a breakfast meeting I got to go to, so I'm actually going to be getting off here any second.
Well, you do things, got plants.
All right, well, I'll talk to you later.
All right, bro.
Bye.
All right, bye.
User disconnected from your channel.
Yo.
Sorry, I was yawning.
What'd you say?
I was yawning, sorry.
Oh. I'm gonna check out this small crop plot. Oh, I'm slowly dying right now. Run for the water, huzzah! Ooh, I really need fiber for everything. Time to start harvesting random plants. Haha, plants. Right now, we are grabbing berries so we don't die. And fiber is the best source for, like, threading. So, we need it to make all sorts of stuff. But it weighs almost like dirt. Okay, nothing. Back. What's up? Hey, Zwoozy, not Zwoozy, Ferniner. What server do you play on, bro? Are you on an official server or non-official? Like a private server or something? Alright, I'll be doing that game giveaway right after this raffle, guys. Right after this raffle.
I'm back. How's the weather treating you up there in Ohio?
Pretty good. It's getting warm here. It's getting pretty fucking warm here. So we had to turn on the AC finally. My wife said enough's enough. She wanted AC. And I need it at night because for some ungodly reason I become hotter than anything else than I would in the day. Don't know why.
It's getting pretty warm over here in Spokane. I think we hit like 89 yesterday. But during the evenings and at night, it's actually getting pretty, it's actually not too bad. We've been hitting the
Rask Zakami, say something in the chat. You have 2 minutes, my friend. 2 minutes. So, to claim your prize.
I'm not roasting my ass off when I am actually trying to sleep.
Rask Zakami, say something in the chat to claim your raffle winnings. I wonder if I'm speaking too low for people to hear me properly. Oh, sweet. Nice. Congratulations, Rask Zakami. Alright guys, here you go, a game giveaway. This is Postal, donated by yours truly, Game Key. So enjoy these free games on Twitch TV. Postal, oh no! Okay. Yeah. Remember guys, 1 GC per ticket, so you can buy 2,000 tickets for 2,000 GC. Don't you worry. Even one ticket can win it, guys. Even one ticket can win it. I've seen it happen. So get those entries in, guys. Get those entries in.
Postal's still in. You got nothing on Hatred.
Postal's kind of violent. Hatred is the extreme violent game that Twitch is basically saying, don't stream. Because it's that crazy. They're not actually saying it, but they're saying, you know, not to stream. They're giving all hints and purposes of it being way too graphically violent, even for mature audiences, because they know kids are just going to click that button anyway and go into the channel. That's why I think there should be like an age verification. Like when you make your account, you must state your age. Even though people will fake it, it should still be there. You know?
See, Camelot, that's where I differ on that opinion right there. GTA 5 is mild compared to Hatred. I've actually played Hatred. Okay, Hatred, his whole thing, the main character, he wants to kill everybody he can freaking kill, and hopefully in the process he gets killed too, because quote, in the opening scene basically humans are the dumbest pieces of shit on earth, and he doesn't want to live on this planet anymore, basically what it is. because he does not, and that's all he does straight up. He just goes out and literally murders people straight up with no other reason other than because the guy wants to. And GTA, shit like that happens in real life all the time. I mean, hell, I'm pretty sure GameKey can attest to that one, being up there and where he's at in Ohio.
What's that?
That shit in GTA, as far as carjackings and people getting shot up.
Oh, that's normal.
Like gangbangers and shit is an everyday thing.
Yeah, that's where I live in Akron. It's like, I've been to both sides of my town. I've been everywhere. There's like the rich neighborhood, and you know it's rich because only doctors, lawyers, and high-class, high-profile jobs live in the area. If you're a high-profile job and you live in the ghetto, you basically buy poor shit all the time. You get the bummiest car or a decently working truck. You don't roll around unless you get a Rolls Royce. Considering my neighborhood is poor as shit, I'm not racist or anything, but there must be some extremely wealthy black families in my neighborhood. Not gonna lie, because Rolls Royces and BMWs are everywhere. Brand new ones. And the houses they park at are the shittiest houses I've ever seen in my life. Like, they're worse than my apartment. They're so dumpy. But the person driving it has the baddest car on the planet. And it's, you know, expensive as shit. And that, I'm not gonna lie, but living beyond your means is not worth it in my town. We are the highest unemployment rate in the country. Ohio is.
No?
Yeah. Ohio took over Michigan's unemployment because people were leaving Ohio to go to Michigan for work. And then when Michigan ran out of work, everyone from Michigan came over to Ohio because all the people missing jobs were right there on the border between Ohio and Michigan. So they came over to Ohio because it's 10 times easier to get a job. Well, after that, we had a major drop in jobs, and basically, yeah, it's impossible to either get a job here because all the jobs are taken, or hey, for that job that's entry level, you must have 2 years experience. And Ohio doesn't care because we're an at-will state. We can fire you without any reason given. So yes, be prepared, guys. Unless your job has a contract and it's in your contract, you're fucked. So that's why I'm going to college. I'm tired of working for bullshit and then getting let go every 6 months to 8 months. I can't survive with a family like that. And I'm not about to start over at minimum wage everywhere I go every 6 to 8 months for $7.50 an hour to $8.50 an hour doing some fucking hard-ass manual labor job or doing a skilled job and working for goddamn peanuts, because they're like, oh, we're going to lay you off at 6 months. We're going to lay you off for 6 months because at 90 days you start over at a fucking base rate again. But don't you worry, you'll get to keep your job after 6 months. It's not like landscaping where, you know, the winter, you're down for just the winter and you can claim unemployment. At 6 months of being down, you start back over at exactly 6 months. And they make it 6 months and 1 day that they bring you back off of being laid off or leave of service or whatever the fuck they want to call that. So, I hate my state, but that's why I'm going for a sports medicine job. I'm going to school for athletic training. I love full contact sports. I figured if I couldn't be in the MMA scene physically, I want to be around it medically. So, sports medicine is my cup of tea, guys. One of my biggest things for the military, that's what I did. You know, I bounce around. I have a lot of medical training, but I can't use it in the real world. So, Let's get a degree for it. Am I right?
Uh-huh.
I mean, it's not every day you take combat life-saving classes and then you come out of the work, you know, the military world and you're like, hey, can I use my skills? No. Why? You're not certified. Well, certified in the military. Oh, well, there's no equivalent for that here. That's what we're running into. There's no equivalent for jobs, for half the jobs you do in the military. Or there's an equivalent, technically, but then you have to go and get a degree in it or go get a state equivalent. And it's like, oh, hey, you're going to pay $2,000. Do you have that right now? No. Well, guess what? That's each time you go to take that test. And it's every 3 to 6 months to take that test. Really? You're like, oh my god, I hate life. It's fucking terrible. Who is the crew? Everyone on the channel, guys. You know, the crew is what I call the community.
I'll say this messed up thing. Freaking United States government posts all these damn advertisements and shit talking about, you know, support your veterans that are coming back home, you know, so that they can have a normal job and provide for their family, but yet there ain't jack shit for us out there, because none of the shit we were taught while in does us a damn bit of good.
No, it doesn't.
In normal life.
No, and I've applied to 3 different jobs for like management positions, and the moment I mentioned I was still in the Marine Corps, like I was doing like reserve duty and stuff, they're like, so you can still get deployed? Yeah. Alright, well, and basically they beat around the bush, ended the interview, and then never called me back. That was the end of that whole interview, the moment they found out, because they didn't want somebody who could basically be deployed for up to 2 years having to sit on a payroll just because his position would be held for 2 years under the Sea and Servicemen's Job Retention Act. It's Soldiers and Sailors Act. Basically, a job must maintain your position. You basically are an extra seat in their hired inventory, and if they don't have that job open, regardless, for you when you get back, that's an immediate lawsuit on their hands. And what's worse is that's why in the state of Ohio, they can let you go as an at-will state. Oh, you're fired. Why? Well, you're a good worker and all, but we just don't need you anymore. Or, hey, why was I fired? Nothing. It's just blank. And that's it. Like, what's crazy is you can have all the recommendations in the world, all of the, you know, recommendation letters and references. It's not going to do you a damn thing if you're not working. And I can tell you right now, as a college student, I make, with my reimbursement money, my reimbursement for going to college through my military benefits, I make enough to support my family for the year. That's literally just paying the bills. That's not my rent. The wife covers that. I cover just the bills for the entire year and any extra slack, and I can barely do that. So that goes to show you how much I mean, I get quite a substantial amount, but I have to put $2,000 on my truck. I get that when I go back to school in the fall. And then I get a little extra money to play with. That's why I'm going to TwitchCon. I have the ability to do so. However, you know, I paid for my flight in advance, and I paid for my TwitchCon tickets in advance for 2 people. I got paid back. That's half my room cost. It's $1,000 for 3 nights. I got half my room cost. And now I'm completely tapped out. It's insane, guys. I love the state of Ohio, but I hate all the bullshit rules. Not to mention, I started streaming because I have a lot of fun with you guys. I get away from all the day-to-day problems. I really do. Especially with Ark here. If you guys see my stream on YouTube, there's like hours of me not talking. The team speak's going, but I'm not saying a damn word. I'm focus mode so hard that I don't know what's being said half the time or at all. And at one point I was so loopy, I think I was like nodding off for a few seconds and then snapping back up and playing like I didn't even notice it. It's crazy. Oh, the raffle closed? All right, who's the winner for Postal? Camelot 2, say something in the chat. You have 2 minutes, my friend, 2 minutes to claim. Oh my god, I have 343 fiber. Oh my god, I'm making so many arrows right now. Camelot 2, we need to become friends on Steam, my friend. What is your Steam in-game name? Well, what is your Steam name?
Stay at home dad anymore, because, shit, all the training I got doesn't do me a damn bit of good, unless I want to go into law enforcement. Like I said earlier tonight, I already went into that and got the hell out, and I will not do that again. I tried going back to school, but with the PTSD and all that shit, because, see, that's like I was telling Doja, I think it was yesterday, my first deployment, my unit got hit with two freaking IEDs on the first damn deployment, and that screwed me so damn hard. They done and diagnosed me with PTSD and agoraphobia.
Wow. Is it because I'm on a hill? My god, you actually do have to irrigate your crop. Oh yep. Shit. Oh, Camelot 2, my bad. What is your Steam email? Or what is your email that's associated with Steam? I can just send it that way. What is your email, my friend? My bad, I screwed up. What up, Andrew JS18? What's going on, man? Doesn't break with stone weapons either. That's amazing. I'm over encumbered. What do I have ridiculous amounts of? Wood. Camelot 2, I need your email so I can send you the game. Andrew JS 18, is it a gaming laptop? Because it's so much better if you get a desktop. So much better to get a desktop. Unless you're getting a laptop for like school and stuff. But if it's just for games, get a desktop. Even for like $400, you can have a sweet desktop to play games on. Currently. Yeah, it must have been a server update. Right now it's still pending install. God damn it. Yeah, I logged back in. They must have had the server down for maintenance for game servers. Come here, you little dodo bird. Ooh, you know what? Where are my fists? Oh, the dodo bird died. Wow, 6 hide. Well, okay. I need 15 wood, huh? Okay. Wooden thatch. Okay, time to make some thatch. Hey. Alright, during this too. You have a good night, man. I'm getting to the email. No, I didn't get a private message. I didn't get a chat, guys. Hell yeah, there you go, Camelot 2. There you go, man. Apparently, it's the middle of the night, and my guy is hot. Let's hunt the lurkers. Oh, dear God.
You think that's bad? I had a glitch on me earlier. Middle of the freaking night, said I was hot, but I was freezing.
It said you were hot and freezing?
Yeah.
That makes no sense.
I know. I just chalked it up that it's freaking early access. It's basically alpha, and yeah, there's gonna be glitches. But even for the stage that the game is at, not even having all the
Queen Aria, what's up? How are you?
It's not bad. It's a lot better than how H1Z1 started. That's for damn sure.
Because of cold burns? That makes no sense.
Trying to tell me I got freezer burn.
You got burnt because it was hot. The ice is cold. It don't matter. Freezer burnt means it got too hot. So you're telling me molecules got excited enough in cold temperatures that they actually burn you legitimately instead of burning you because they're too cold. Literally bursting blood cells. Because they freeze. Not because they got it too excited and actually burst or melt. Hey, J-Kill, I don't have the mug with me right now. It's actually extremely dirty. And I haven't bothered to wash it, like, since the wife used it for her shake. As far as I know, it could be in the freezer with the shake still in it. Yeah, I just shat myself. Exactly, I shit. Said I just defecated. Exactly.
Yeah, I don't know if you heard earlier, but when you go to, when you actually start setting up the planning plots, make sure when you shit yourself to pick it up. You can actually use it for fertilizer.
Yeah, that's what's hilarious.
Yeah, or you could press Z and make yourself take a shit.
Really?
Yep. Once you've been running around for a while, you can actually hit Z and you'll actually drop a load.
Yeah, it says you're not ready to defecate just yet, so I believe that's when your food bar is maxed out. You'll just, if you press Z when your food bar is white, you'll immediately defecate. But if you don't press Z, your food bar will stay maxed out until you do take a shit. And what's hilarious is it happens in the funniest of moments. Oh my god,
I got mentioned, it makes me wonder if the characters that we play, if they're like genetically modified or some shit, because who the hell lays a perfect turd ball?
Even dinosaurs. We're on a world. We're experiments, man. We shouldn't even be here, technically. Oh my god, I have 5 metal on my person right now. Can be refined in a forge. If I can ever get there.
600-pound woman gives birth to 40-pound baby.
What? Is that a real...
Yeah, it's real.
40-pound baby. What is this, like, elephant woman?
All I know is that the woman's actually an Australian, and she was 600 pounds. And she gave birth to a 40-pound baby.
Is that baby, like, all fat?
By the look of the picture, yeah, it's pretty much all fat.
No, I'm saying the baby. That's scary, my friend. 40-pound baby? That's extremely scary, because if that baby's all fat, did its bones grow properly? Is its organs okay? Like, that's extremely scary. And then, did she get that, like, done in vitro? Because someone who literally, would have sex with that woman? I'm sorry, 600 pounds, that's a lot of women.
Oh yeah, that's a lot of women.
Huh? That's extremely scary. I'm a guy and I'm afraid of that woman.
I'm sorry, but... I mean, yeah, I don't like my women being skinny as hell. Toothpicks, but I'm sorry, that's too damn big. That's taking your life in your own hands big.
She took her life in her own hands.
Apparently the baby remains in a healthy state.
Yeah, I'm actually more afraid about the child having birth defects than anything. Like life-threatening birth defects. Did they say the baby was healthy or anything?
Well, they're saying that it's remaining in a healthy state, so I'm guessing it's pretty healthy.
Oh yeah, J-Kill in my chat is from Australia. He's a young kid. Pretty cool, dude. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she'd just squish you if she rolled over. Literally, she would break bones, dude. Like, that's scary.
Hell, you'd suffocate before anybody would ever hear the screams.
Yeah, actually, you would. If she rolled over on your legs and you couldn't get out, the skin on your legs would have blood coming from its pores for oxygen. I'm not lying about that.
Judging by the size of the nurse behind the baby in this photo, the baby almost looks like it's pretty the size of a 5-year-old.
Wow. That's insane. That's gonna be one big kid. Like, is like the body like huge on the baby?
Yeah, the body's big as you know that that glyph picture that goes around Facebook and shit of that little fat Asian kid that turns around and goes, "Haha, you're funny. I eat you last."
Yeah.
This kid's about the same size as that kid.
Wow. That's huge.
What's messed up is, I think it was a couple of years ago, up until that happened in Australia this year, there's some chick from Texas that gave, it was a 550-pound woman. She actually gave birth to a 35-pound kid, and at the time was the largest baby ever known to have been born, up until that lady in Australia had that 40-pound.
Jake Hill, that's actually done away with. Yep. There was too much trolling going on, so I don't use that no more.
In freaking Texas, the doctors originally thought she was gonna have triplets, and when they took the baby by C-section, they all freaked out when they found out that it was just one 35-pound kid.
What? Wow.
Yeah.
That's insane. Jake Hill, I know it was hilarious, but if you haven't seen how big the following is lately, that's why, because in 10 days, we jumped from 300 to, like, 1,100 people, and then we've been growing steadily since.
You're actually sitting at almost 1,000. Actually, according to my side, you're sitting at 1,441 now.
Yeah, I know. I've grown these past few days. Just these past 2 days from playing Ark, I was at 1,400. Oh no, I'm exhausted. I'm dehydrated. I pass out. Fuck, I need to run to the water. It's right there. Oh my god, are you serious? It's raining. Wake the fuck up. It's raining.
Let's just hope a carnivore doesn't come around.
Oh, dude, shut up. I don't need that kind of luck.
Hey, at least Blood's not online right now. He freaking punched me to hell, knocked me out, and tried to drag my ass to the freaking Megalodons.
That's funny.
I woke up just as he got me to the water.
Oh my god.
And I was sitting up on the hill watching him.
Oh, jeez. Way to go, teammate. Oh my god, I'm like right there. I'm literally making like a little makeshift base right here just because. Need to drop some resources, basically. Whoa, a little lightheaded from that. Okay, fuckers, it is Friday, it is 8 o'clock, we should not be pending anymore, we should be ready to fucking go.
No shit.
Apparently, I don't think they have any ARC servers officially.
You know, my clan went through this same damn thing back when the original Black Ops came out with game servers. I mean, they're not a bad company. They're just a little slow on the rollout. I mean, they should have already had servers set up.
Yeah.
With the base settings. Or just sitting there and waiting for people to start building servers. It's like I was telling Blood, like I was telling Crow, you know.
Yeah.
I could easily, you know, within maybe 3-4 days, I could have him a website up and running on with the domain name and everything, and shit wouldn't cost him shit, honestly. I mean, normal charge when I do shit like that, I usually go by the hour, but shit, situations like this, considering I know the situation he's in, because pretty much the same situation I'm in. Constantly broke, next to nothing in the bank. And if you do have anything in the bank, you're pretty much, yeah,
going right,
I don't
back
know
to
if
kids,
I want to touch
bills,
that shit
family.
Not. Exactly. I mean,
like, that's the situation for all of us. Like, you know, Borderland Games, myself, Deceptive Cobras, Blood Crow. Like, we're all in that situation. It's like, we can't exactly spend money, but when we have just a little bit on top of, you know, bills, a little free money, stuff like this comes along, and we're like, okay, we can get this game, you know, we spent $25, not a big buy.
Right. And
that's why I don't mind, like for me, I can go without paying like half my electric bill or half my gas in the summer. Why? Because I can make it all up when I go back to school. And that's where August comes in. You know, August is my month I can skimp on the bills. Oh my god, look at that turd. That's like the size of like a big dog. If that's the size of like three big dogs there. And look at that. It's like a body and a half curled up into a ball. That's insane. That is a huge fucking turd. We're going to pick it up. And then we're going to play with it.
Go throw it at a donut.
Just don't do like I did by accident. When you got in your quick slot and you're tapping through all your berries real quick because you don't have nothing else to eat and you accidentally hit the turd.
Why, what's it do?
My health started dropping so goddamn fast I thought I was about to die.
I threw it through the dinosaur. Nope, there it goes. Let's watch it roll. Oh, it stopped in the water. Take it. That does not sound weird. Yep, we took a turn. We took one for the team, literally. And I just shit. You know what? I'm going to get it. Is this it? No. It's like right around here, too. Your turd's like a small version of poop. I think it rolled down here. Did it? Is that it? No. I shit and I don't know where it is. I lost my shit, guys. No joke. Game key is now a monkey. Yes, I am. A funky monkey.
Yeah, supposedly that big ass tower thing you see over there. Supposedly, from what I've read,
yeah.
At one point in time, coming in the future, you'll be able to go to those towers, and you'll be able to actually
summon a
transfer. You'll actually be able to transfer your character over to another freaking server.
Oh yeah.
And then of course there's some places, I'm not sure where they go, but the whole ultimate beasts and stuff, but they're basically bosses. But there's going to be objects that you can get that are what's known as sacrificial items.
Yeah.
That you'll go to these places and put them in, and it summons these ultimate freaking beasts that you have to freaking fight. And part of the end game, which is basically where you get off the island and shit, or as they put it, you ascend.
Oh, geez.
Which adds in more to what I was telling Crow yesterday. My whole theory on this game is this. We were abducted by aliens, placed on this freaking planet, and basically as an experiment to see what the hell we would do.
Yeah. I think that's what we are too. We're an experiment. Is what the actual game says is you're an experiment. You're on a land where there's dinosaurs and none of this should exist. And then you have those things. That's an ark. Back to my cave to show you guys what I've been working on. I'm gonna run back there. I'm gonna kill everything on the way too. Everything that's killable. That is potentially like worth killing. Basically, that's the birds and the spitter dudes that blind you. Let's see. Oh yeah, let's make our slingshot right now. Are you kidding me? I can't make the slingshot. Why not? Oh, I need wood. Really? Oh, I dropped it back there. Oh well, it's not too hard to get wood when you have an axe. Alright, I'll go to the Ark here in a minute. Let me go back to my base and drop everything.
System, if you kill another player and you start looting their stuff, usually if you like double click on their arc implant or like the skin for the hat or the skin for the saddle, it won't give it to you. But if you click the take all into inventory, you actually will end up with their specimen tag as well as their freaking skins.
Yeah, you can do that already if you take all. That's all fixed. And I'm wondering if your specimen tag can be upgraded. because your specimen tag already gives you like base stats or whatever. Look what it says. Species Homo sapien epoch 74. Attributes: intelligence, dexterity, adaptability. I'm wondering if you can get more like a better implant. Maybe if that's
they pop off with the whole species thing, that makes me wonder if maybe later on down the road in the game, if they're gonna bring in other freaking species that you can play as, because I was reading on the wiki for it of features they were wanting to bring in. They're talking about like dino human / dino body parts.
Oh, like lizard people basically.
Yeah, hybrids.
Oh shit, that's gonna be awesome.
And drivable vehicles.
Well yeah, you mentioned that earlier.
That's gonna be crazy right there, the drivable vehicles. Especially with the being able to mount weapons on them. I still say screw that. I want a brontosaurus with like three of the mini level 60 miniguns on each front leg in full freaking metal armor. It's a tank.
A super poo.
I can just imagine some of the things people are going to do when the mod tools come out, though. That's like, there's so many games that come out nowadays that they don't even put mod support in. That's one of the things that surprised me with this, because they never said anything about there being mod support in this game. And then I went in and was looking, and sure enough, there's support for mods. They just haven't released the mod tools.
Yes, it eats berries. Percent. You guys saw this firsthand right here. 87% taming effectiveness. Mm-hmm. Here we go. We're trying to tame a damn turtle. Oh shit. Every little increase is just like 0.5% negative. Thatch 55, huh?
Something I hope they change is one of the things you can learn to make with the freaking flare gun. They need to make it where it burns whatever you shoot with it.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at.
Because I fired two of them at Crow, and all they did was just get real bright and blind you for like 2 seconds.
Oh, geez.
Actually, kind of reminded me of white phosphorus.
That's pretty much just a signal play.
Yeah, but you shoot somebody even with a damn signal flare, it's gonna burn their ass.
We're trying. We've got it knocked out. It's eating berries.
You can't make a mortar and pestle yet, can you?
Yeah, I can.
If you do the mortar and pestle and then do the spoiled meat with the narco berries, you'll make the narcotic.
And yeah, the narcotic I already have that.
Hell, I used my narcotic on that dildo that I had. Yeah. I freaking used the narcotic on it, and as soon as the narcotic started taking effect, it was like within 2 minutes it was at 50%.
I don't even know what the things are called, the turtles, but I'm trying to tame one.
Yeah, supposedly you can ride the turtles.
No, you can. You can.
Your goddamn living tree's flipping out again.
I know, right? You saw that too?
Yeah, I've seen it happen on my side too. What's really messed up is at a distance it looks almost like they're in 2D instead of 3D.
Oh, that's exactly what they look like too. And it's so funny because on my big 30-hour stream, I literally look like I walked into a headbanging forest. It's too funny. Alright, I'm making a storage right next to it, too. If I die, all this stuff is here. There we go. Skin back. Put that metal in there. Give me the berries back. Let's see, what's the other big commodity? I'll keep the stone on me. Some of that, or some flint.
But I swear I hit level 60 and I get where I can build the frickin' minigun. I'm going right dead after those freaking birds. I got a vendetta on those damn things. I literally got triple killed. One spawn right after the other. I told it to just randomly spawn me. And three times in a row, it spawned me in the same damn spot with the same bird killing me.
Yeah, I know.
Spawn system's still better than Call of Duty, though.
Carbonemus. Nope, can't make them. I made Raptor Saddle, though.
Now all you gotta do is knock out a raptor.
Yep. I'll use my turtle to help save my ass. And to hold crafting materials. My turtle's gonna be a badass with everything. I'm gonna make it sit at the cave. Oh my God. So many resources. Let's turn off this fire. Let's go back over. Let's get a whole bunch of wood. Should be in here. And we'll just go. Drop. Taming. 78.7%. Okay. I am in the best spot ever. Yeah, and still barely tamed. Seems like you're paying no attention to chat. What? You mean I'm barely paying attention to chat? Chat's not really been that crazy active. Uh-oh. Are you kidding me? Don't tell me the servers are about to go offline. Have 8 meat and I can't. Oh, yep, servers just went offline. Are you kidding me? Motherfucker. Oh, oh my God.
Yep, sure as hell did. I just refreshed the Steam server list.
Yep, VDON is not on right now. God damn it. What the fuck?
If you want to know the name of that turtle, Genki, here it is.
It is a. Yeah. Yep, our Carbonemus, Obimimus, whatever. I can't pronounce the last one too well.
I've been doing this.
Look at that. 70. That's game servers right there. That is game servers. I bet you game servers is giving them a deal for all this too. Just all official servers, you know. Official EU official servers, 99. EU official servers 108. Wow.
It's tell the truth, I want to get one of the fucking crocodiles.
Friends? Who the hell's in that? Apparently one of my friends is in that French server. Favorites. Just Valkyrie. Huh. Glory fucking raptors. Yep. Twitch.tv Matt CKZ. Wow. $127 million ARK. Millions ARK, huh? What are you guys talking with? We are talking with TeamSpeak, Jake Hill.
Oh wow, I just found a server in the list called Mountain Dew and Bud Light.
Oh my god. I found Fanta. It's got 30 people, max. I wish our server would upgrade. The lowest ping. Zanko Public? What? Wow. Or twitch.tv/MateCKZ. Hey, guess what? I got out of school yesterday and fell asleep the second after. Ooh, saucy 13. That ain't cool. That's some serious sleeping. /24/7 official server. 13.
Looks like the other server. Looks like Vaden's server's on its way back up.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's showing 0 out of 0 players, and it usually does that when it's still coming up.
Alright then, guys in the stream, I know I'm probably going to drop frames like a true pro, but I'm going to update ARK right now. Well, that was fast. I downloaded. I didn't even drop frames. And Rust is seeing those kinds of updates too. Wow.
Yeah, if only DayZ standalone and frickin' H1Z wanted to get them like that.
Uh-oh. Are you telling me I'm not gonna download right now? Because it's Rust. Wow, it's almost done downloading, and it won't let me download the last 11.3 megabytes. Oh, but it tells me completely different. Okay. There we go. Done. Are you kidding me? It's not done updating? What? Okay, anytime now, computer. No. I hate Steam Big Picture mode.
Oh god, so do I.
That should only be a thing for the Steam machines.
Yeah, of which technically you can build your own now, and they've actually released SteamOS where you straight download it and freaking install it on a machine. If my laptop wouldn't have died when I got my desktop done,
there we
I
go.
Was actually going to turn my laptop into one.
Damn it. Okay. I'm loading in right now, guys. We're going right back. The server didn't update, but it kicked me off. I guess it's like a refresh. Well, I'm stuck. Chilling in wait. Oh my god, server rollback. Are you fucking kidding me? Really? Wow. Wow, rollback. Rollback is gay.
At least they're not doing server wipes.
Yeah, at least they're not doing server wipes. They're doing rollbacks. Hey, guess what? I got that badass amount of metal from this thing. Not anymore.
I think it's funny as hell with H1Z1. They've turned the whole server wipes into a damn joke. Everybody that's been around for the server wipes, whenever they, the last two they've done, they've given everybody an exclusive t-shirt skin. This is like, I survived PW1 and I survived PW2.
Really?
Yeah.
So that's what they're doing is jokes now?
Well, pretty much. I mean, their community manager, I used to have their community manager, Laptop 65, on my freaking friends list. And I had a problem with the game. And so did Void. Void actually got caught in one of their ban waves. And he didn't even do shit. All he did was crash while he was in the freaking test server.
Oh, geez.
And freaking auto-banned him. It took him almost 2 weeks to get his account unbanned and reinstate. And all the while, you know, people were talking about all sorts of shit going on in the game, you know. So I popped in and was like, well, you know what? I said, when you're on a PvE server, players really shouldn't be exploiting the mechanic of the zombies just to be able to gank another player to get their freaking gun or their freaking backpack or shit like that. I said, I've had my party wiped out twice because of that. I said, it's not that hard to change the AI routines to be able to fix that. And he pops off. He goes, yeah, well, people on the internet are jerks. I was like, your community manager for Daybreak Games, and you're going to pop off with that? We got a problem. I had over 8 pages on the Steam forums. But nice. He's been backing me up on it. And only thing he could say was, oh, well, people are jerks. And, you know, people should be able to kill other players. I was like, yeah, not in the PvE.
Yeah, not in a PvE server.
Yeah, PvP, yes. Battle Royale, yes. Not PvE. Needless to say, after I called him out, I told him flat out, I said, look, man. I said, we've been friends on Steam for a while, but your attitude has gotten really bad. I said, they picked you to be community manager. I don't even know. I said, because the things that you're saying should never be said to the freaking community.
Yeah.
He got all pissy and removed me off his friends list. Oh well. I've still got half the freaking dev team from Pandemic, the ones that do Plague Inc. on my friends list anyway.
Nice.
Mainly because I caught a glitch. I was playing the game on the Steam version of the game. And I posted to Facebook because this one mutated virus that I created wiped out all the population of Earth within 24 days. And so I posted the screenshot on the internet. And in the related, underneath the Facebook post, was a link to the Pirate Bay for the bootleg version of Plague Inc. served up by Facebook's own servers for the ad.
Wow.
I posted on the boards for Plague Inc. about it with screenshots. And within 5 minutes, I had half the dev team sending me friends requests and asking me about it and everything else.
Oh, wow, there's 27 people in here. Holy crap.
Yep. I think the most I've ever had on my stream, I think it was the night I was playing Modern Warfare 2 here about a month ago. Almost. It'll be a month next week. But, I think
there you
I
go,
had
Jayco.
9 people. 9 or 10, something like that. I'm just gonna get my green screen set up and get another monitor because I can't game and run OBS.
This is great.
And all that.
I think I'm gonna get a Dillo.
Nice.
I mean, I can kill it, but I think I'm gonna get this Dillo. It'll be really nice to have because of it spitting, and I'll be able to knock out monsters while this is dealing damage, and then I can pull my Dillo back and tame another one. That's what I'm excited about. I'm excited.
Not to mention, you get like 3 or 4 of those Dillos following you.
I need to kill enough dodo birds. Dillo for the win. Heck yeah. Oh my god, we're almost at halfway. We're at roughly 8 meat, 7 raw, 1 uncooked. Wow, 1 cooked meat spoils in over an hour. And 1 raw meat has over a half an hour. Oh my god. That's a fix. That's a new fix. That just happened.
Yeah, because the freaking meat in that, man, that stuff was spoiling way too quick.
Oh, apparently I picked up my dead body at some point because I have a second Parasaur Ark Founder's saddle. Just going to drop that. Oh, I need food. I'll eat up a ton of berries. Yes, Saucy, yes they do. For a minute, I thought this Dillo was talking to me.
The hallucinations of sleep deprivation.
No, it really did sound that way when it brought its head up. Listen. Because it's eating meat. The only sad part, you have to make sure it's got meat.
Doja talking about an army of dodos. Yeah, let's see your army of dodos against our army of freaking dillos. That's actually what I was going to do if I wanted to find enough dillos. I was going to end up with like five or six.
Snap, here we go. Here we go.
But I was gonna try and get like 5 or 6 dillos to follow me around. Just freaking wait and come across something. I don't want to fight on my own and just be like, smack it one time and let them take over.
I don't know about you guys, but I love this game. Hell yeah, we're about to have a dillo. About to have a dillo. Hell yeah. Come on, Dillo, eat some more. You're right there. And you have 2 food left. Oh my god. Hell yeah. Alright, I'm about to have you, Dillo. You're about to be my new best friend. We're about to go attack a turtle. And you're going to fight it for me. Dilophosaur. Hell yeah. Naming it Blood Crow. How do you guys like my new pet, Blood Crow? Yep, let's go.
Oh yeah, supposedly something else I was reading. We're talking about bringing in full-on armor sets and shit for the domesticated dinos.
Oh yeah, that's gonna be awesome. Oh yeah, you know what? Come here. Access inventory. We want all those narco berries back. Hell yeah, here we go. let's get back to base. My base, that is.
I think I'm gonna call it a night, you guys. I'm starting to get tired as hell. My eyes are watering.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's already well over crack of daylight over here. I'm almost 6 in the morning. I'll be on later today, though.
It killed me, it killed me. Damn it. I tried. There's Blood Crow's base. I marked it. There's me. I think it's International Donut Day. It may be. Holy fuck. Where do all you people come from? Crazy payballs. Payballs! Come here, birdie. I'm not too far from my body, guys. If you see where I'm at my first little base. So I could potentially make it back to my body with no problem right now, which I'm going for it. Should be like right over here. Here we go. The rampage is real. Poor birds. Hell yeah, poor birds. Dodos don't stand a chance, not in my neighborhood. Nope. I actually got scared for a minute, thinking that giant thing was a velociraptor. Oh, I'm around my body. It's gotta be over here on the other side of these rocks. Yeah, I'm around my body right now. Going down here to the water. The ish water. Okay, here we go. Dive into the water, or not. Yep, four dodos. Bum 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 bum. Yeah. I hate how stones look like loot bags. Dude, I'm in that same boat. It's like, yeah, loot. Nope. Damn it. Where is my body? Like, it's right here around this water. It's gotta be, like, right here. I hope the turtle didn't eat my body. Hobo ate my taco. Thank you, my friend. Hang out, stick around, get to see the alert system. Don't you worry, man. I want to give you the proper thank you.
User joined your channel.
Buddy.
What up, man?
Did you get your server thing running yet?
No. It's still pending. It's still freaking pending. I bet you my body's over there. Not over here.
But your buddy's what?
Blood Crow. Yeah, it's his server. But
go
there's like...
Hurry up. Go wake him up. Go to his house right now. And get him to do it. Come on. Let's go. Come on.
We can't log into the site right now.
Is he not up though?
No, I have the login info, but you can't log in and check it again. He had this problem a few hours ago. Basically, it's not up, and we can't do shit about it.
This is why we can't have nice things.
You have joined your channel.
Somebody joined my channel. It's my channel, by the way.
Who left, anyway? Oh, what up, Mr. Bushi?
Ugh, morning.
No, not him.
Been up since 7:51 last night, man.
I smell like a Bushi. Fuck you.
How you been, Mr.
Bushi?
What's a
Bushi anyways?
Just a warrior. Japanese.
I was thinking of blood.
No, it's Japanese for warrior. About 1100s, Heian period.
So you're Bush.
Yeah, this is Mr. Bushi.
Yeah, Mr. Bush. Like George W. Bush? But with an I? Or W? I don't know. Oh!